We love you, bud.
Freedom!
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 Liberté!
Liberté!
Freedom!
Freedom!
Liberté!
Liberté!
Freedom!
Freedom!
Liberté!
Liberté!
Thank you. Wow. I love having guys like Vlad because you know what? When you look at this symbol, it doesn't really occur a whole bunch of like love and unity and hugs and stuff like that. But when you look at Vlad with that pretty face and Cullen with those wonderful t-shirts and stuff, it just, you know what? It's, you don't need to say a damn thing. You need to walk up to somebody with one of those t-shirts and they say, okay, now we get it, right? Now, when people see me walking in with this t-shirt, they're wondering what's going on. So a lot of people will actually say to me, excuse me, what is that all about? And I go, well, let me explain. Number one, I have to explain this way, because I'll tell you. There's two things I'm going to do. I'm going to give you the really easy explanation, and I'm going to read it to you, because I want to make sure that nobody misses the point. Because when we were in Quebec, people were coming up to us, what is that all about? What's that symbol about? What's going on? We don't talk enough about how easy this is. Here it is. Does everybody know how to spell oppression? It starts with O, right?
Yeah.
Right. So it's an O. So, do you think somebody's crossed the line a little bit lately?
Yeah.
Yeah, they've crossed the line. And so we're going to draw the line.
Yeah.
Okay? We've even seen the First Nations people of Manitoba draw their own version of the line with a red feather in the middle with a dream circle as the outside. Absolutely amazing. So what I'd love to see in the future is that each individual province or country can come up with this symbol, which everybody recognizes, but their own individual touch. And one of these days, when we have that on the line, we'll have a little calendar of all the wonderful people's symbols. It's amazing, okay? So let me just give you a little bit of a read here, just to explain to you one more time. The line is a national symbol of resistance created by the people during a time of struggle and corruption and tyranny.
Yeah.
The line is a leaderless resistance movement and symbol. Whenever you see the symbol in the future, it's not technically us that spray painted it or marked it down or walked in with some stuff on a mark on a bag or a t-shirt and stuff. It's anybody. Nobody can come after us and say, you did this. No, we didn't. We're just showing up having a good time here at Queen's Park, right?
Right.
Considering the fact that we're working very closely with nationwide civil liberties groups that have banded together to fight corruption, tyranny, and ensure that people's civil liberties and freedoms are maintained, the line symbol is an image used as a unifying symbol of partnership and resistance to corruption.
Aho.
Aho.
We want to make sure that no matter what happens with what groups and what mainstream media, that we will never go down. I know I keep mentioning, and some people know that we're prepared to die for our cause. I certainly am. I don't know about you guys.
Yeah.
But I'd rather die than be in my basement wondering what's going on.
Yeah.
I will. Absolutely. Give me 1 second, bro. And you know what? Whatever God I believe in or creation, whatever religion I believe in, is I know that every day I show up once again out there to show people what the possible light of love for my people are, it's going to be me. And if I can be here to hold the energy for all the people that someday will fill this walkway all the way in that middle, that's where I see the future, and I see us all the way down to Bloor. That's going to happen. It's only a matter of time. It always starts like this. So guys, before I introduce the next speaker, I'll pass over the mic here to Colin. He's got something to say. Thank you very much, Lamont. Okay, guys, I just would like you to give your undivided attention to Joel. He's from Vaccine Choice Canada. He has a few words for you. Give it up for Vaccine Choice Canada, Joel.
Thank you very much. As you well know, Vaccine Choice Canada launched legal action against the government leaders on every level, federal, provincial, and municipal, and the health leaders, you know their names, on July the 6th. That case is progressing. Masking injunctions for the public in general and schools in particular are coming. They are imminent. I wanted to let you know that as an update. And I wanted to let you know we have a brand new button, Stand Up for Freedom, right here. And it's a $1 donation to the legal fund of Vaccine Choice Canada. I will circulate afterwards, so we don't interrupt any speakers here. Come see me, and the buttons are available. We appreciate your support. Thanks very much.